You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Ready to stand out? Army ROTC prepares you not only as a college student, but as a strong leader, allowing you to earn the rank of second lieutenant. You will be eligible for full tuition, merit-based scholarships, and develop leadership skills essential for your future. Start strong and enhance your college experience. Visit your campus Army ROTC representative today. To find out how you can earn up to a full tuition scholarship, visit goarmy.com/podcast to locate your closest ROTC program today. Army officers inspire strength in others. Paid for by the United States Army.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I only have a certain budget.
No problem. Right now at the LASIK Vision Institute, get 20% off LASIK when treated in April. That can be over $900 off when treating both eyes, plus guaranteed financing options. So visit getlvilasik.com today to start your journey towards 20/20 vision.
Must mention this promotion to be treated in April of 2024 to qualify. 20% off standard price of wave light procedure. Cannot be combined with any other offers. Go to getlvilasik.com for details.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I'm so busy right now.
We offer a mix of convenient days and times, including 30-minute virtual appointments to fit your schedule.
I would love it, but I have astigmatism.
We treat thousands of patients with astigmatism every month with great outcomes. The LASIK Vision Institute is making your journey towards 20/20 vision all about you. So visit getlvilasik.com today to start your LASIK journey.
I am Conor McGregor, multiple weight MMA champion. I'm a fighter and I've been through many battles in the octagon. Many consider my fights in the octagon heroic, but the real life heroes are those men and women who fight to protect us every day. The real life fighters, the real life heroes, are the firefighters and police officers. These first responders are true heroes because these brave men and women put themselves in the line of danger every single day protecting us all. The Tunnel to TRRS Foundation ensures that first responders from fire, EMS and police departments who are killed in the line of duty with young children have a home without the burden of a mortgage. They are my heroes. They need our help today. I'd like to ask you to join me in donating $11 a month to support their efforts. Your $11 a month honors and supports our first responders. Please call now at 1-844-BRAVEST or visit tunneltotowers.org.
Hi, I'm Mike, founder of DollarShaveClub.com. What is DollarShaveClub.com? Well, for a dollar a month, we send high-quality razors right to your door. Yeah, a dollar. Are the blades any good? No. Our blades are f***ing great. Each razor has stainless steel blades, an aloe vera lubricating strip, and a pivot head. It's so gentle, a toddler could use it. And do you like spending $20 a month on brand name razors? 19 go to Roger Federer. I'm good at tennis.
And do you think your razor needs a vibrating handle, a flashlight, a back scratcher, and 10 blades? Your handsome ass grandfather had one blade and polio.
Looking good, pop up!
Stop paying for shave tech you don't need. And stop forgetting to buy your blades every month. Alejandro and I are gonna ship them right to you. We're not just selling razors, we're also making new jobs. Alejandra, what were you doing last month?
Not working.
What are you doing now?
Working.
I'm no Vanderbilt, but this train makes hay. So stop forgetting to buy your blades every month and start deciding where you're gonna stack all those dollar bills I'm saving you. We are DollarShaveClub.com, and the party is on.
I know karate, I know jiu-jitsu, I drive like a gangster when I'm coming to see you.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, CEO of Quicken Loans, America's largest mortgage lender. Spring will be here soon, so if buying a new home is on your to-do list, right now is the time to call Quicken Loans. Learn about which mortgage options make sense for you and get a jump on your competition. With our exclusive Rate Shield approval, the low rate you lock today is protected for up to 90 days while you shop for your new home. With a Rate Shield approval, if rates go up, your low rate stays locked. But if rates go down, you get that new, even lower rate. Either way, you win. Talk to us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com to take advantage. Here's another great reason to work with us. For a record 9 years in a row, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction for primary mortgage origination. Again, to lock in today's low mortgage interest rate and get the security of our exclusive Rate Shield approval, call us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com.
For J.D. Power award information, visit jdpower.com. Rate Shield approval only valid on certain 30-year fixed rate loans. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Hi, welcome to the Subway ad for the new Sesame Ginger Glazed Chicken Signature Wrap. How would you like it?
I'll take a...
Sports announcer at home?
Yeah, how do you...
We just know.
My wife picks up the new signature wrap. It's got double the rotisserie-style chicken mixed with a sesame ginger glaze. She appears annoyed at me, but she shrugs it off. Those sweet and savory flavors are calling her name. She lifts the wrap and... She takes the bite! Incredible! And now she's closing the door on my... Subway, make it what you want.
Limited time only at participating restaurants. Double meat base and average 6-inch sub.
The following program contains coarse language and adult themes. Listener discretion is advised.
Welcome into the program, ladies and gentlemen. Again, I am, well, I guess I say again, but this is Rick Robinson. This is my show. We do the Rick Robinson Show every Tuesday through Friday, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern. This is the opening segment of the show, and do we have things to talk about? I don't even really know where to start other than just getting some stuff off my chest. So if you don't follow me on X, you're not going to have seen this yet. And if you follow me on X, you've probably already read along, but you get to listen to it anyway. Because it's my show. I do what I want. Anyway, so we're here. We're live. And I have some news for the heathers of the world that are currently clutching their pearls over Donald Trump and the dicks of the world that currently have their hands in their pockets over Donald Trump. And you can take that inference however you want it. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't really know when this happened, but at some point we decided there were rules to how we were going to do things, and we expected everybody to follow those same rules. The problem is they're not, and we still are. And let me explain, because this may actually take a minute, but I'm going to explain anyway, because I feel like I kind of need to, because I've had enough. I get it. Everybody wants to be the good guy. Everybody wants to play by the rules. Everybody wants to do Marcus of Queensberry. Nobody wants bloodletting during debates. I get that too, especially for primaries. I do not like the fact that Donald Trump has made primaries a blood sport again. I don't like it, but that's where we live. But the problem is, while we're so busy wringing our hands over whether the guy that we have at the top of the ticket is a monster or not, we know that the guy at the top of their ticket is a monster, and we know most of their party is a monster. But we're so busy fighting amongst ourselves because we have to be the kinder, gentler Republicans that we've lost our way. And the problem with us losing our way, and I promise I'm going to bring all this home in a second, but the problem with us losing our way, especially in the way that we have, is we are barreling towards a cliff. So for all of you right now that are like, well, I don't really like Biden and I don't really like Trump and I don't really know what I'm going to do. Look, I'm never going to tell you who to vote for, but I am going to be blunt with you for a second. So if you don't want to hear it, go ahead and turn the show off for a little bit. Maybe come back later. For those of you listening live, for those of you listening podcast, you can always fast forward if you want. But I'm about to be really blunt and you're probably not going to like it. Because the simple fact of the matter is, I didn't want this geriatric grudge match either. I did everything I could to try to steer us away from this geriatric grudge match. The problem is, the powers that be wanted the geriatric grudge match because they were convinced they could beat Trump again. The problem is, they didn't legitimately beat him the last time. And like I said, if you don't like what I'm saying right now, feel free to turn it off. But we've seen the data. The data is there. You explain to me how 10 million more people voted for him in 2020 than voted for him in 2016, and yet somehow Biden still got the magic number. Sometimes in a few places by just a few hundred votes. This is what I'm talking about. It doesn't make sense for it to have happened on the scale that it happened in so many different places over and over and over again, all in the middle of the night while nobody was paying attention. I watched it happen in 2020. It made zero sense to me. Because we shut everything down at around midnight my time. Actually, I think it was closer to midnight Eastern. We shut everything down around midnight Eastern on election night because all the swing state districts were like, oh, we have an issue. We're going to start counting again and have everything up and running again by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. So we all went to bed. And then I woke up, and I know I've said this 100 times, but I feel like I have to say it again. I woke up to get ready to start doing the morning show that we were doing at the time because we were in the middle of what started as 2 weeks to slow the spread that became 3 years to slow the spread. And the spread still hasn't slowed, by the way, if you want to get really honest about it. But here's my thing, though. All of it. None of this makes any sense. But for everybody now to be like, well, he beat him the last time, so he's probably going to beat him again. I don't think so. Not unless they manage to find a way to get the fix in. And if we have enough people on our side decide to stay home, that may happen again. Because we already know that a lot of people on the left are not going to be voting for Joe Biden. They've told him as much. They're showing him as much everywhere that he goes. What I didn't expect to see is all of the people that every time Donald Trump makes a public appearance right now, which is few and far between because they have him chained up in a courtroom. I said what I said. The crowd absolutely loves him. They're chanting his name. They're chanting 4 more years. We love Trump. 4 more years. We love Trump. 4 more years. Joe Biden can't get that energy from anywhere. Hell, he made a couple of jokes at a union meeting the other day that people kind of blithely chuckled to, and then you pan back to the camera, and even the people that were behind him looked like they were in a hostage video. Then he goes and tries to take pictures with people. He tries to step in close enough to get a picture with a guy. That guy actually recoils from him just enough that you notice, so he moves in just a little bit more to get the picture, and that's it. So not only that, so let's compare and contrast the rallies, because that's what we're talking about. But also let's compare and contrast the two recent trips to what amount to gas station trips. Donald Trump went to a bodega in Harlem, of all places, and was greeted like a champion of the people. Joe Biden walked into a gas station, nobody knew who the fuck he was. This is what I'm talking about. This is why we need to start being serious about where we are, what we're doing, and who we're going to vote for. Because the simple fact of the matter is, ladies and gentlemen, we don't know whether Donald Trump is a monster or not. We do know Joe Biden is a monster. But let me tell you something that a lot of people won't tell you, and I'm just going to shoot straight with you. Most of the stuff that you read about our founding fathers in the history books was bullshit. They were fierce people. They did whatever they had to do, whenever they had to do it, to make sure that they didn't get hung. This is what I'm talking about. And the problem that I have, and I'll get into this after what's supposed to be the monologue break, but the monologue is going to keep going after the break. The problem that I have is we have this hand-wringing thing going on with the Republican Party now, not realizing that we are literally in a knife fight, not only with ourselves, with our own group, but with the other group that wants us dead on a burning boat that is sinking at the same time. And we're fighting with each other and fighting our enemies at the same time because we can't pick a side. And let me just say this to you as we get ready to take the first break. If you are trying to play it neutral, you are picking a side. So I certainly hope that as we careen closer and closer to this cliff, when we finally go off of it, it's kicking and screaming, because a lot of us, all we're trying to do is find the damn brakes on this thing for right now. When we finally slide off that cliff because you couldn't pick a side, then I hope that your moral high ground also doubles as a parachute. We're going to take a quick break, and then I still have more on this topic when we come back. And if you haven't figured it out yet, I'm more than a little bit fired up about this, so we're going to keep going with that after the break. All right, you're listening to me live. First break. Lots more show. Stay tuned. Rick Robinson. This is my show. KLRradio.com. And on the Bible,
I'm a decent man. No, I ain't perfect, but I'm learning how to be the best I can. But I got demons collecting dust, and I buried them so damn far down so they can't find their way back up. So don't stay my
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Ready to stand out? Army ROTC prepares you not only as a college student, but as a strong leader, allowing you to earn the rank of second lieutenant. You will be eligible for full tuition, merit-based scholarships, and develop leadership skills essential for your future. Start strong and enhance your college experience. Visit your campus Army ROTC representative today. To find out how you can earn up to a full tuition scholarship, visit goarmy.com/podcast to locate your closest ROTC program today. Army officers inspire strength in others. Paid for by the United States Army.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I only have a certain budget.
No problem. Right now at the LASIK Vision Institute, get 20% off LASIK when treated in April. That can be over $900 off when treating both eyes, plus guaranteed financing options. So visit getlvilasik.com today to start your journey towards 20/20 vision.
Must mention this promotion to be treated in April of 2024 to qualify. 20% off standard price of wavelength procedure. Cannot be combined with any other offers. Go to getlvilasik.com for details.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I'm so busy right now.
We offer a mix of convenient days and times, including 30-minute virtual appointments to fit your schedule.
I would love it, but I have astigmatism.
We treat thousands of patients with astigmatism every month with great outcomes. The LASIK Vision Institute is making your journey towards 20/20 vision all about you. So visit getlvilasik.com today to start your LASIK journey.
I am Conor McGregor, multiple weight MMA champion. I'm a fighter and I've been through many battles in the octagon. Many consider my fights in the octagon heroic, but the real life heroes are those men and women who fight to protect us every day. The real life fighters, the real life heroes, are the firefighters and police officers. These first responders are true heroes, because these brave men and women put themselves in the line of danger every single day protecting us all. The Tunnel to Towers Foundation ensures that first responders from fire, EMS and police departments who are killed in the line of duty with young children have a home without the burden of a mortgage. They are my heroes. They need our help today. I'd like to ask you to join me in donating $11 a month to support their efforts. Your $11 a month honors and supports our first responders. Please call now at 1-844-BRAVEST or visit tunneltotowers.org.
Hi, I'm Mike, founder of DollarShaveClub.com. What is DollarShaveClub.com? Well, for a dollar a month, we send high-quality razors right to your door. Yeah, a dollar. Are the blades any good? No. Our blades are f***ing great. Each razor has stainless steel blades, an aloe vera lubricating strip, and a pivot head. It's so gentle a toddler could use it. And do you like spending $20 a month on brand name razors? 19 go to Roger Federer. I'm good at tennis.
And do you think your razor needs a vibrating handle, a flashlight, a back scratcher, and 10 blades? Your handsome ass grandfather had one blade and polio.
Looking good, pop up!
Stop paying for shave tech you don't need. And stop forgetting to buy your blades every month. Alejandro and I are gonna ship them right to you. We're not just selling razors, we're also making new jobs. Alejandra, what were you doing last month?
Not working.
What are you doing now?
Working.
I'm no Vanderbilt, but this train makes hay.
So stop forgetting to buy your blades every month and start deciding where you're gonna stack all those dollar bills I'm saving you. We are DollarShaveClub.com, and the party is on.
I know karate, I know jiu-jitsu, I drive like a gangster when I'm coming to see you.
The following program contains coarse language and adult themes. Listener discretion is advised.
Good evening, my people. I've been
the chandeliers. The wine and dining, the menu is blood, sweat, and tears. Everybody ready, raining down confetti. Champions are born right now. Ain't about the glamour, click goes the hammer. Run when you hear that sound.
Gentlemen, again, this is the Rick Robinson Show. We do this thing every Monday, I'm sorry, Tuesday through Friday, KLRradio.com, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 to 4 Central. So just because I haven't done this yet, if you're working for the weekend, you got about one day left. If you do the whole 9 to 5 thing, and if you're on the East Coast, you got a little less than an hour, a little over an hour and a half. If you're in God's time zone, you got a little over 2.5. And if you're on the West Coast, why the hell haven't you moved? And Mountain, nobody cares. Just saying. All right, anyway, so we are back. We are live. Hope everybody's having a great Thursday afternoon. I'm a little heated, so we're going to get back to what we were talking about a second ago. So two things. One, moral relativism is going to kill this country. Let me explain. Because moral relativism is going to kill this country. So and it's happened to other people before us, and it will probably happen to the people that come after us if we wind up losing our heads over all of this. But let me explain. So moral relativism is when you expect that the people that you are at odds with are going to behave in the same manner and fashion that you do, because that, in your opinion, is what civilized society is supposed to do. So let me tell you who made those mistakes. One, the Native Americans. What happened to them? They're now mostly on social media whining about how we stole their land, when in reality we just kicked their ass and took it from them. Is that a nice thing to say? No, not really, but it's the truth. You know who else suffered from moral relativism? The British. Do you know how this bunch of ragtag rebels defeated the Brits not once but twice? By not playing by the rules. As a matter of fact, when they came back for round two, we decided we were done with their bullshit. So what we did is a bunch of our guys, and if you've ever watched Michael Loftus do one of his stand-up routines, you already know about this because it's one of his bits that he still does to this day, and it's absolutely hilarious. But if you recall, or for those of you who may not, in the War of 1812, the reason we won is because everybody was like, well, the British are here, they're down there, and blah, we need to do this, and we need to do that. And a bunch of new people, like Davy Crockett and a few others, said, rules? Fuck the rules, let's just go down there and kill them while they sleep. And that's exactly what we did. So a bunch of our boys went down there, caught them sleeping, and slaughtered the whole damn group. Do you realize that if the UN was in existence during the War of 1812, we would have been tried for war crimes? But we won. Here's the thing, and this is what I keep trying to explain to people. The rules that we put in place and the institutions that we put in place are designed to protect us from the things that we did ourselves, whether they were intentional or not. Our immigration system exists because at some point we understood that things could have been done a lot differently, and that should the shoe ever be on the other foot, we don't want to be playing cowboys and Indians in reverse, except now we are. Nobody wants to talk about it yet. Which is, again, another reason why moral relativism is going to kill this country, because as soon as Ilhan Omar told the world that the Muslims that were coming into this country were not coming here to assimilate but to colonize, they should have all been made to leave. Every last one of them. Because there's a reason why they keep calling us the colonizers. But I need you to understand something. If colonizing is bad, why is it okay for them to say that's why they're here? And why didn't that set off anybody's spidey senses? Because we have this moral relativism. Well, we try to be good people, so we assume everybody else is going to try to be good people. Let me explain to you exactly how far behind the eight ball that we are as far as this whole moral relativism bullshit argument that we are having amongst ourselves while our country is burning down. AOC is on record stating the following. No doesn't mean stop. It just means find another way. Because they're the Davy Crockett's. They're the ones not playing by the rules. We're the ones expecting everybody to play by our rules. And then when they don't, we wring our hands and say, well, we may have lost, but at least we didn't stoop to their level. That's going to work great until we lose our heads, guys. This is where we are. When it was just us and the Democrats, and the Democrats were a little bit crazier than us, and they decided to start fighting a little bit dirty, and we decided we weren't going to fight dirty back, and we lost, and it was, oh, good game, guys, we'll get them next time. You know, that was one thing. But now they're importing people that want to kill us. And they have told us that they want to kill us. We now have, on American soil, people chanting death to America. I never thought that I would see a day when people were chanting to murder the country that I was born in, that I absolutely love, and that nobody would say or do anything about it. And just so nobody goes sideways on me, I'm not talking about you and me. I'm talking about the people that are supposed to be in charge. But they don't care anymore. You know why they don't care anymore? Because they're too busy lining their own pockets. A lot of this is the thing, folks, and this is why you keep noticing that we keep playing the same shell games in Congress, because they have figured out that the Biden family and the, well, I'm sorry, let me fix that. They have figured out that the Biden crime family is lining their pockets in Ukraine, and they all want a piece of the pie. They've also figured out that the Biden crime family has reactivated War Inc. and has us funding both sides of the Hamas-Israel-Iran conflict. I guess all three sides, technically. Although, all technically, two sides are one and the same, I guess. I mean, that's the irony. Everybody talks about last Saturday night. I'm going to get to that, too, because there's a physics professor who put out something that I think you guys need to hear. And then I'm going to explain why you shouldn't panic about it quite yet, because it doesn't mean what you're going to think it's going to mean. But we'll probably get to that after the break here in a minute. But here's the thing. Our founding fathers, in a lot of ways, were monsters. Just ask the British. But they did whatever they had to do to win. So then they got to be the ones to write the history. And at some point, we put them on pedestals, and we made them superhuman, and we made them completely virtuous. And that is part of the reason why so many people who are now using our own history against us can get us pissed off, because, well, George Washington didn't do that stuff, and Thomas, yeah, I'm pretty sure he probably did. So did Thomas Jefferson. I mean, hell, the whole reason we have the flawed separation of church and state doctrine is because Thomas Jefferson was a secularist, and he wanted the country to be one too. So it got taken too far, because separation of church and state doesn't mean what they've told you that it meant all the way through school, until they pretty much stopped talking about it at all, because it was originally founded to make sure that we didn't wind up with a George Washington version of the Bible and the United States Church of Christ, or something along those lines, because that's exactly what happened. That's why they left. The only church that existed until the Church of England was the Catholic Church. There was a Reformation, lots of things started being changed, and then the king found a way to start, again, lining his pockets. So he formed the Church of England. And he made it illegal for anybody who was an English subject to be anything other than a member of the Church of England. But nobody talks about the dirty little secrets of the Catholic Church back then either, which is that basically salvation was only for the rich and you had to pay to get there. I mean, Christianity is a flawed system. It is, just like any other flawed system. It's not perfect. But as long as you hold on to your personal faith, and as long as you keep your walk with God as clear and as pure as possible, then you don't have anything to worry about. The reason I'm bringing all of this up is because we have this idealized, romanticized version of our history, and it's not true. It's just not. I think the wind is about to try to kill my internet again. Fun times. I don't know what it is that when we get windy, my internet says, huh, just kidding. All right, anyway, we're going to take a quick break so I can see if I can get that sorted out, because it's about bottom of the hour anyway, so hang on just a second. We'll be back in just a few.
Hey.
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Ready to stand out? Army ROTC prepares you not only as a college student, but as a strong leader, allowing you to earn the rank of second lieutenant. You will be eligible for full tuition, merit-based scholarships, and develop leadership skills essential for your future. Start strong and enhance your college experience. Visit your campus Army ROTC representative today. To find out how you can earn up to a full tuition scholarship, visit goarmy.com/podcast to locate your closest ROTC program today. Army officers inspire strength in others. Paid for by the United States Army.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I only have a certain budget.
No problem. Right now at the LASIK Vision Institute, get 20% off LASIK when treated in April. That can be over $900 off when treating both eyes, plus guaranteed financing options. So visit GetLVILASIK.com today to start your journey towards 20/20 vision.
Must mention this promotion and be treated in April of 2024 to qualify. 20% off standard price of wavelight procedure. Cannot be combined with any other offers. Go to GetLVILASIK.com for details.
At the LASIK Vision Institute, we know LASIK is a big decision, and every one of our patients is unique. That's why we customize your LASIK journey to you.
I'm so busy right now.
We offer a mix of convenient days and times, including 30-minute virtual appointments to fit your schedule.
I would love it, but I have astigmatism.
We treat thousands of patients with astigmatism every month with great outcomes. The LASIK Vision Institute is making your journey towards 20/20 vision all about you. So visit GetLVILASIK.com today to start your LASIK journey.
I am Conor McGregor, multiple weight MMA champion. I'm a fighter and I've been through many battles in the octagon. Many consider my fights in the octagon heroic, but the real life heroes are those men and women who fight to protect us every day. The real life fighters, the real life heroes, are the firefighters and police officers. These first responders are true heroes, because these brave men and women put themselves in the line of danger every single day protecting us all. The Tunnel to TRRS Foundation ensures that first responders from fire, EMS and police departments who are killed in the line of duty with young children have a home without the burden of a mortgage. They are my heroes. They need our help today. I'd like to ask you to join me in donating $11 a month to support their efforts. Your $11 a month honors and supports our first responders. Please call now at 1-844-BRAVEST or visit tunneltotrrs.org.
Hi, I'm Mike, founder of DollarShaveClub.com. What is DollarShaveClub.com? Well, for a dollar a month, we send high-quality razors right to your door. Yeah, a dollar. Are the blades any good? No. Our blades are f***ing great. Each razor has stainless steel blades and aloe vera lubricating strip and a pivot head. It's so gentle a toddler could use it. And do you like spending $20 a month on brand name razors? 19 go to Roger Federer. I'm good at tennis.
And do you think your razor needs a vibrating handle, a flashlight, a back scratcher, and 10 blades? Your handsome ass grandfather had one blade and polio. Looking good, pop up! Stop paying for shave tech you don't need. And stop forgetting to buy your blades every month. Alejandro and I are gonna ship them right to you. We're not just selling razors, we're also making new jobs. Alejandra, what were you doing last month?
Not working.
What are you doing now?
Working.
I'm no Vanderbilt, but this train makes hay. So stop forgetting to buy your blades every month and start deciding where you're gonna stack all those dollar bills I'm saving you. We are DollarShaveClub.com, and the party is on.
I know karate, I know jiu-jitsu, I drive like a gangster when I'm coming to see you.
The following program contains coarse language and adult themes. Listener discretion is advised.
We'll be right back.
into the program, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to keep things running as long as we can. We're starting to, I don't know what is going on with my router lately, but it seems like about the same time every day, unless I come in to the studio like 30 minutes early and do a full reset of the modem and everything. About halfway through the first hour, we start getting DNS conflicts. So we're going to keep things running for as long as we can. If I wind up losing connection, I'm just not going to worry about spinning it back up. You guys will just get partials are over for today. Not because I'm trying to be a dick or anything, but just because I have other things that I need to do, and it'll take about 20 minutes to spin everything back up anyway if it winds up going completely down. But here we are. We're still going, and for some reason, some of it's working, some of it's not. So we're just going to keep going for as long as we can. We get through the full 2 hours, great. If not, we'll go for as long as we can. But I kind of felt like this song was appropriate for the next story that I'm going to bring up, and kind of felt like it, well, actually, it kind of needs a Spanish translation. Because weird moment. So John Leguizamo, who's now one of the, I guess, rotating people on The Daily Show, because now, like, I guess, old dude Stewart does it, like, Mondays, and then I think they have a few different people that are doing it now. But apparently, you know, the world's worst Mario had a take on the fact that there seemed to be a growing number of Latinos that are coming out in favor of Trump, and he didn't seem to like it very much. So let's give this a listen. Now watch, it won't play it.
It's a band.
Yeah, I figured this was going to happen. It was only letting me play what had buffered because my internet is being stupid. All right, so anyway. well, it's going to try. Maybe I'll just let it keep spinning. Maybe it'll figure itself out. So anyway, this is actually from, I'll just read the tweet that this is captured from. Daily Show's John Leguizamo has a meltdown and smashed a piñata after admitting Donald Trump's strategy is winning over Latino voters. The thing that hurts me the most is that his lazy-ass strategy is actually working. It looks like the Democrats are in trouble, and it's going to try to load Twitter, and then that's not going to work either because my internet is slowly on a cascade failure. But anyway, so you've probably heard it if you run in the same news circles that I do. So I'm going to start pulling this stuff down before it pulls the signal down everywhere else. And try to get it going again, possibly without crashing everything here in a minute. But anyway, so yeah, meltdowns are happening all over. Joy Reid, this was another clip I really wanted to play today, but I can't make it work. This is why I'm just going to start coming in here early and grabbing all the stuff that I need and getting it loaded into the actual decks instead of trying to play it from sourcing. As I think sometimes I make things cranky by trying to do that. But anyway, Joy Reid, and I talked about this with on the show, whatever, yesterday with Stacey. But Joy Reid basically, I mean, this is not a direct quote, but it's close enough. My DEI bays are going after that rich white cracker. Go DEI. I mean, that's basically what she said on her own show while she's wearing Trump's hair, which is cultural appropriation, by the way. I'm just saying. If your culture isn't my costume, then my culture can't be your costume. You shouldn't have blonde hair. Just saying. And it also shouldn't be being worn creepily in a Trump-style wig. Just saying. But anyway. More to the point, though. So, and this is something else that really upsets me. And I talked about this a little bit yesterday, but I'm going to go ahead and talk about it again today, too. Because this is really sitting on my heart. And I know you're like, whoa. He's like, everybody's like, whoa, you really are a preacher, because that's a preacher thing. Yeah, I am, or I was, until I started doing this. But this is something that has really, really, really been bothering me. And it's a simple fact of growing up in a time where, I grew up in a time where shows like The Jeffersons were on. Shows like All in the Family were on. Shows like In the Heat of the Night were on, showing that people of color were making progress. As a matter of fact, in the pilot episode of The Jeffersons, the lady, the cleaning lady in the final sentence of the first show ever looked at the interracial couple. This was in the 70s. And asked, when did we make it, and why did nobody tell me? How have we gone so far backwards in less than 50 years? I don't understand what, well, I can't say that. I do understand what happened. Race Bait Inc. found out they could make money by keeping everybody mad at each other and showing the disparity and showing the differences. But the problem was they weren't honest about what was actually causing those differences either. Most of the differences between white culture and black culture and how they are handled in America, as far as on a political spectrum, have more to do with the Democrats couching everything that they try to do in the soft bigotry of low expectations. Well, you're not as advantaged as I am, so I'm going to help you. That sounds really good, especially if you feel like you're stuck, until you realize that the people are telling you that are only trying to placate you so they can keep you stuck. The thing that makes zero sense to me, and I've been saying this for a very, very long time, school choice is a perfect example, because that gives people of color the ability to put their children in schools that are actually working for their children, not the schools that they're stuck with based on their geography. Ladies and gentlemen, we aren't the ones that wanted to put the black people in the ghettos. That was the Democrats. Now, some of it was, you know, I mean, people like to be around their I mean, this is going to sound racist, and I don't mean it to, but it's just the truth. People like to be around their own kind, so they do naturally congregate together to a point. But at the same time, if you didn't see it before, you must see it now. You have to, especially if you live in one of the inner cities that are being taken over by migrants because the southern border states have had enough and they're starting to ship them to you. You have to see the difference, because now you aren't the lowest rung on the ladder anymore. So they don't care about you anymore. This is what we've been trying to tell you all along. But you didn't want to see it and you didn't want to hear it. And I'm not saying that as an I told you so. I'm saying that because you need to listen to me. If you live in one of these inner cities and you're watching these migrants take your jobs and basically take over your kids' playgrounds and everything else, you have to understand this is exactly what we tried to warn you about and have been for years. When we told you there was a great replacement theory that the left was working with, your leadership told you that it was a racist dog whistle. Are you getting it yet? None of anything that we have ever said to try to wake you up has been meant to be mean. And by we, I mean most of the right as a whole, including Rush Limbaugh, because we saw all of this coming. We knew it was coming. We didn't realize to the extent. We didn't realize how far along it had gotten, especially in the last 4 years. It's like everything just went into light speed. But it's time to start waking up. When you are seeing paid agitators, and that's what they are, from coast to coast, shouting about Palestine, these are the same groups the left uses for everything. So for you to be thinking that your leadership doesn't understand what's going on, or that your leadership can't be behind this, the leadership has been behind all of it. Because they want to destabilize us. There's a reason that Joe Biden is still going around saying we have the world's strongest economy, and we have this, and we have that. Because he doesn't want you to realize how bad it is. Because in order for their next phase to pop off, we have to crumble. And they've nearly gotten us there. I need you to look at this seriously with me. You now have kids that are walking out of school almost on the daily, either to protest on behalf of Palestine or to protest on behalf of Israel. And I'm not talking about college kids. I'm talking about like high school kids, middle school kids. It's like, yeah, screw it, we're leaving. Now you've got a school in Utah where they staged a walkout because the administration wasn't listening to them, because they've got kids coming to school in furry costumes that are harassing them during class time. And the administration of the school is doing absolutely nothing about it. I need you to hear me. The world is falling apart. The left is eating itself, and we're caught in the middle. This is why you now have the less extreme part of the left trying to wake up to the fact of how exactly far extreme the leftist extreme side has gotten, because a lot of leftists are waking up and going, wait, I didn't sign on for this whole we hate Israel thing. To hell, I thought it was the Republicans that were the KKK. We've been trying to tell you. We weren't the problem. But they needed you to see us as the problem, because if you saw us as the problem, you kept voting for them. That's why I'm so pissed off with Republican leadership right now. Because they are still trying to make abortion a national issue. You know why they're still trying to make abortion a national issue? Because they need it to be able to fundraise. Because they have gotten just as heavily into Outrage Inc. as the left has. We didn't see it until it was too late. Now here we are. This is why they did everything they could on both sides to stop Donald Trump from accomplishing anything. And made everything that he did sound racist. They have made him sound like he is hated. But nothing could be further from the truth. Every time that man is in public, he is greeted with cheers and people screaming 4 more years. And then you have Biden in public and almost nobody's there and it's quiet and it's somber until somebody puts on a laugh light. And then everybody starts looking like they're freaking hostages as soon as the cameras are off or about to be off. Now, I'm not going to keep harping on this. I promise I'm not. But I need you to understand that the problem is with all of this, is that we have lost our way. We have lost our way so much that now our side is being led around by emotion just as much as the left. And that is the problem. They have both sides so wrapped up in emotion right now that nobody's thinking about anything. All I'm wanting to do is find the brakes. That's it. That's all I'm wanting to do. I want to find the brakes to stop what we're doing so we can take a moment to assess everything and see what we can do to fix it, because our world is on fire. And I don't just mean America. I mean the whole damn thing is pretty much on fire right now. We are in the middle of World War III and nobody's talking about it yet. Has it officially popped off in a nuclear holocaust yet? No, but it's probably pretty damn close. And this leads to the next thing that I want to talk about, and then we probably will go ahead and wrap. A little bit early, because, like I said, I'm surprised my internet connection has held out this long. Because it's being really, really wonky. But anyway, so this goes on, this goes into something, and again, I'm going to have to paraphrase it, because I don't have it in front of me anymore, because I was going to pull it up from the source material, and I can't do that right now, because my internet's barely working. So, this is kind of a paraphrase thing. There was a physicist who put out, or actually relayed information that was put out through X, about the fact that it was a statistical impossibility for everything to have gone the way it did on Saturday, on last Saturday night for Israel, without it being from the hand of God. And I have to agree, because in that instance, when everything was popping off the way that it was, you had ground controllers, you had flight crew, you had people controlling the missile batteries, all of the above, all moving as if they were of one mind. That is impossible. For there to be a 99% capture rate on that is impossible. Even a 90% capture rate would have been phenomenal. But there's never not been a time that those systems in some way have failed to have at least a few of those missiles get through. Until now. And then you couple that with the ones that didn't even get off the ground and the ones that didn't make it to their targets. And even a couple drones that got mixed up in power lines. Now, I'm not telling you that this is part of prophecy, because remember, there's a prophecy that says that Israel will be attacked from the north and that it will be apparent to everyone that it was an act of God that stopped it. I'm not saying that's this. I'm saying it's the wind-up before the pitch, though. This was God trying to get everybody's attention and remind them, hey, these are my people. Stop it. Or else. But I also don't think this was the biggest part of the show yet, and I don't know when the biggest part of the show is going to happen, if I'm being honest, because we just don't know. I don't think this was the biggest part of the show yet, because while the scripture, and I believe it was Ezekiel 38, again, I don't have, all of my notes are online, and I can't get to them right now, but I'm pretty sure it was Ezekiel 38 that basically referenced Israel being attacked. And so simply put, there's a scripture in there that talks about Israel being attacked from the north with Syria. It talks about Syria, Persia, and Magog, I believe, is the other one. So all of the biblical scholars firmly believe that Magog is likely Russia. So the fact that Russia is starting to get involved in this in the periphery should be a road sign for everybody. Even if you don't believe in my faith, you have to really go back and look, because the Bible's pretty historically accurate. So there's a good chance that the stuff that hasn't happened yet is also probably going to be accurate, even if you don't believe that there is a God and that the Son of God is real. That's not an argument I'm going to have with you. I know what my faith says, you know what your faith says, and we can agree to disagree if we don't have the same one. I don't have an issue with that. But it's time for us to start seriously looking at exactly how crazy everything has gotten. So then you take into account some of the other road signs, like men's hearts failing them out of fear. Now, I'm not saying that, again, we're in the middle of that. I'm saying that we are starting to get to the roadside pointing to that, because you now have men who shouldn't be dropping dead of heart attacks for no apparent cause other than possible vaccine side effects. Who knows what that's going to do further down the road? There's also the part of the prophecies of Revelations that talk about there being an explosion of knowledge without understanding. Kind of sounds like we're all walking around with computers in our pockets. We have all of the world's knowledge at our fingertips, but don't understand any of it. Kind of sounds like what they're talking about. I'm not telling you the end of the world is near, and I'm not standing on the street corner holding up the sign, "Repent now, Jesus can..." No, that's not what this is about. This is about letting you know that if we don't put people in leadership positions that actually give a damn about what happens to us, instead of being elected into office and saying things like "Somali first," then eventually our world is going to finish burning. And the people that have set us against one another, that started the fires, are going to be cheering because they got what they wanted. And again, as I get ready to wrap up, because we're going to cut things off early today since we're having an internet issue, because I don't know how much longer it's going to hold out, and I don't want to leave you guys mid-thought. But Donald Trump may be a monster. Joe Biden is definitely a monster. Sometimes it takes a monster to fell a monster. If Trump can put the brakes on this stuff long enough for us to take a long, hard look at it and see what we need to do next, why doesn't he deserve your vote? Because you know what's going to happen if he doesn't win. Even if you hate him. The other problem that I have is when they make it so abundantly apparent that this is all political theater to try to keep him from being able to run for re-election because they know they can't beat him on the issues. And you know how I know it's all political theater? Because just today it was announced that a trial that could adversely affect Biden's re-election has been postponed until after the election. Everything is broken. The people that are in charge do not care about you and me, so we have got to start caring about ourselves. And right now, the only path forward that I see is putting Donald Trump back in the White House for the 4 years that he can have. Because even if nothing else, he will stop some of the bleeding. I don't know what will happen. I don't know what comes after. But I do know that we can't have another 4 years of Joe Biden. We can't. We won't survive it. Think about where we would be at right now if Trump hadn't won in 2016. You and I probably wouldn't even be allowed to be speaking right now. I would probably be in a re-education camp, or worse. Because this is what they've wanted all along. And they have the groups spun up now to do what they need them to do. This is what we've been trying to tell you. All of this has been planned. All of this has been coordinated. All of this has been underway for over 100 years. Because there are people that decided a long time ago that the great experiment of the United States of America needed to fail because it was their stepping stone to power to make that happen. And that is where we are today. if you don't think things could get any worse, just look at Venezuela. Because they can. The only way we stop this is if we come together, those of us that aren't insane, on both sides, and say, look, enough is enough. This is what we're going to do for right now. This is who we're putting in charge. Then we're going to take a look at the rest of you fuckers. Then we're going to figure out who's on our side and who's not, and send the rest of you fuckers home. Because it really is that simple. These people are supposed to be working for us. If you needed any other proof that Donald Trump was actually trying to work for us for at least most of the 4 years that he was in office, let's not forget that the man donated his salary to charity. He actually lost some of his net worth while he was in the White House. He's losing even more of it now. I don't like him either. But if I have to choose between more of what we have now and a chance to get some back of what we had for the first 3 years of his term, it's no contest. None. There's absolutely no contest. None. All right, we're going to get ready to wrap things up. Today's a shorter show than usual because I'm trying to make sure nothing craps out right in the middle of me doing the whole show thing like it did the last time. Kind of surprised everything stayed up as long as it has because I'm still getting DNS errors everywhere. So I'm not really sure how one thing is staying connected and I'm losing connection with everything else, but this is kind of what happened the last time. Then I started trying to fix it and made it all worse while I was on the air, which is why we're going to go ahead and wrap things early today. So we may or may not do a makeup hour tomorrow. I don't know. It depends on if I, just keep running into the same issue. But anyway. All right. So on that note, it is time for me to remind you where you can find me for the moment. Later tonight, I'll be back doing Jen and Rick, as long as we can get things under control here at the mothership as far as the interwebs. That'll be 10 p.m. Eastern. Tomorrow, same bat time, same bat channel, maybe kicking off even a little bit earlier, staying a little bit later, because I kind of feel like I owe you guys an hour, so we'll figure that out tomorrow. Then back doing He Said, She Said with Aggie Rekin. Then Ordy and I are kind of toying around with the idea of doing a makeup, because there's all kinds of MK Ultra, CIA and JFK stuff popping off on the mainstream, so we're kind of feeling like juxtaposition needs to get into some of that, because that's our shtick, yo. So we may or may not do a makeup this Saturday night. If we do, it'll be 11 p.m. Eastern, right here on KLRradio.com, and I'll be back Sunday night doing the America Off the Rails show at 10 p.m. Eastern as the closing act. I know I haven't been doing that one for the last few weeks, but I'm going to get back into that again. And then I'll be off on Monday. When I'm not doing all that, you can find me as the executive producer of the Loftus Party podcast. You can find me as the editor-in-chief of the Digital Beacon, the new Twitter exclusive news outlet that we're going to start putting things out on. I'm kind of thinking I'm going to go more with like a news magazine kind of format, because I'm hitting up a couple people about like doing men's mental health Mondays, and a few other things as we start building it. Just because I don't really want to do the same thing everybody else is doing. So we're going to find ways to do things differently, which is part of the reason why we're launching as an exclusive to X as of probably for at least the first 12 months. Then if that goes well enough, what we may wind up doing is setting up a Substack and tying everything to that too, so that we can have sections where if you want the extra stuff, you can kick us some coinage and do that too. But anyway, so now we've reached the point where I have to tell you this particular show is over, so have a great rest of your day, guys.
What? Over? Did you say over? Nothing is over until we decide it is! Was it over when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor? Hell no!
Closing time. Open all the doors and let you out into the world.
This isn't over until I say it's over!
Closing time.
Well, that's great. That's just fucking great, man. Now what the fuck are we supposed to do? Game over, man. Game over.
Closing time. Time for you to go out to the places you will be from.
you, Oklahoma. What a great crowd. I love you.